From the East Williamsburg Econo Lodge, Ilithios!
You're driving late at night, smoke in the rear view. Loneliness is fine when you're searching for a breakthrough, and you never change your mind, and your pain is like a bright light. Dancing in the night, and your name is Santa Fe. You got me μακρινή. Oh, πρόσωπο σου φεύγει. I can see it in your eyes, and you say you won't betray us. Oh, got me μακρινή. Do you feel our suffering? Turn the lights on when there's darkness in the room, and the pharmacist and the bureaucrat after endless operation. Oh, we can end your suffering. End your suffering. And your name is Santa Fe. Oh, yeah, I'll be marketing. When they found you in your bed, oh, we thought you died, but after endless operations, oh, we can end your suffering. End your suffering. And your name is Santa Fe. End your suffering. End your suffering.
Why don't we play a cover song for y'all?
Miles and miles away, you're miles and miles away, you're miles and miles away.
What you came for, but I'm not the same anymore. But a happy moon, it never mattered anyway. You know it's true, we never mattered anyway. the shit we live with. Is this the shit we live with? I am the best that you live with.
Thanks for tuning in, everyone. We're Ilithios. Just super grateful that you're all hanging out with us on a Saturday night. This is, I guess, our single release party. This next song is the single. I'm not going to stop talking. Justin, take us away. Choking on the politics like we're children in a fog of apart this fortress with one last touch. Don't know who, I don't know who, that we should finally believe. I know you haven't seen me yet. Yesterday, called Way of the Future. Justin did a remix for that, which is insane. If you guys are like into really industrial, kind of wild shit, it's wild, man. Yeah, exactly. This is a song from the next album I'm working on.
But not what I do.
If there's magic in the moves, well, there is no beauty in what we do. Why don't you stay? Why don't you stay? I want you stay in your own damn place. We're just two messes of being in an impossible world, waiting on endless time.
Should we take a break now?
Can we take a break now?
Yeah. I didn't realize how quick, I was just like, five songs, that's gonna go by quick. We're going really fast, aren't we? Sorry. Yeah. Okay. Seriously, how fast was that?
All right. So thank you guys. That was completely awesome. It was really great to hear the full band for some of that stuff. Before we get into asking about that, I want to talk about Way of the Future. Came out last week.
Yes.
It's a single, and there are three remixes.
Yes.
On it. You mentioned one by Justin. What are the other two, and how are they stylistically different?
Sweet. So the other two remixes are from one is from Old Man of the Woods, which is an artist from Virginia, who's a label mate with me on Totally Real Records, and she does like these really cool synth kind of keyboard, like haunting kind of stuff. And I think this was just like her first time ever, just even just like doing a remix. So we just sent the stems, and we're just like, whatever happens, happens. And she just took them and just like messed with timing, came up with like her own kind of drum ideas and all that stuff, and it was really amazing. And the other one is the JLM, which is Jeremiah from Stereoactive, which is kind of like my record guy. And he did like a great dance remix. He's a drummer. We used to play together in Coyote Eyes, so he's like a genius on the drums, like hitting stuff. That's my mom. So yeah.
So after the single, do you have anything else planning that's coming out this summer or?
I started an open collaboration kind of thing where I'm just taking songs and just throwing them out there to people, yourself included. You knew that.
Well, I don't know if the record company wants us to announce anything like that. My lawyer still has some shit to look at, honestly.
I am working on some collaborations. There's one that's very exciting that's kind of blowing my mind. There's one that's really exciting, and then there's I have a couple other things going on, like record-wise. I don't know. It's so hard. It's just like there's just so much that I don't know what to do first. It's like.
No, I mean, that's, you know, a lot of bands are kind of in here like, oh, we had the pandemic and we don't know, we got nothing planned, nothing for the future, you know, living day by day. It's amazing that you have stuff in the oven that's being cooked right now. So everyone at home, definitely follow Ilithios on bandNada. You will be, I got to plug bandNada contractually.
Of course. So,
follow them on bandNada. You're watching this, it's just easy, click the follow button, and you can be alerted when there are live streams and all the new stuff will be in the bandNada feed when it comes out.
And make sure people are donating so that we can pay the bandNada people too.
I want to talk, the proceeds to Way of the Future went to a good cause.
Yes, we didn't raise a shit ton of money. We raised like 150, but that's not too bad for a single. We are doing it to the community fund for the AAPI Stop Asian Hate kind of organization that is allocating funds to various groups that are like have different goals, like big and small. So it's just like either changing the way that we approach that people kind of think about violence in the Asian community against Asian Americans, and educating, and maybe even more direct things. So basically it's like this big organization that takes the money and they give it to the right people to help educate and prevent further violence. So.
That is amazing. I want to ask you, what moved you, for those of you who don't know, I'm sure most of you watching this are probably already a Ilithios super fan, so you probably know, but pretty much all Ilithios up until now has been you solo or maybe with one other person performing live, and now you have the full band. What moved you to take that approach?
It's always been my goal to do exactly that. I think I wanted to make sure that it wasn't just a bedroom project for me. Like, and I think just having people around, just really, there's no difference substitute for live music. It's just like when you play with other people, everything changes. And when you're in a room kind of experiencing live music, it just really, it resonates more. So it's just like, cool, the record sounds cool. But if I just go out there and just, you know, karaoke to it, it doesn't work. You know, and
yeah, there's nothing like a drummer specifically being there and just somebody hitting shit in the background.
Yeah, rhythm section. And then even like with these songs, like I was very like these are the songs, let's just learn them. But everyone here today, like they all brought their own kind of flourishes that just kind of brought them to another level, like with whether it's through mastery of pedals and sound effects or interesting rhythms or just like incredible, I don't want to say swollen pickle, but just like.
The what? Nothing. Explain yourself. I can't see the chat, but I know people are asking about that. What? Go ahead.
No, just like, you know, like, it's just like on songs, I'm just like, this can't be reproduced. It's a synth bass. It's perfection. And then someone says, like, I have a pedal called the swollen pickle. And I'm just like, I'll take it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, Swollen Pickle, one of the main reasons to play with other musicians, apparently, according to Ilithios.
Yeah.
So I want to talk to the other musicians for a minute about what they had to go through in the process of learning
and
these songs. Justin, do you want to grab that mic, or Benji, or whoever? I was going to ask Justin a question first, so maybe Justin should get on it.
Hi.
So I got to ask right off the bat, yeah. Feel free. We don't have Rhodey, so you have to move that mic yourself. Actually, we do. We have Zach. He's 30 things, and Rhodey is one of them. Stage manager. You have a Tascam 4-track over there. I don't know if anyone at home knows these things and caught it on the video. What's going through that machine?
I don't know. It's not much.
it's just your station, and he just set up in front of you?
He just says, press play and move this up, move that up.
So you actually have, it's not just it's like different faders from tracks and stuff?
Yeah, I think he's running, chords. Yeah, chords, different.
Got it.
I'm just fading them in and out. But no, I've never used a 4-track before. It would be cool, though.
Of the stuff that you're playing on guitar, how much of that is adapted from, like, electronic instruments, and how much of it is straight-up guitar parts?
I'd say it's 100% guitar parts. Yeah, just sort of listening to the record.
I'm going to ask Julie a similar question about bass, and how many of those bass lines are, like, kind of synth bass lines that you kind of had to adapt for a bass guitar, or what? How did you go across about that process?
God, Manny, you're tall.
You can use your mic, too. It's cool.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Oh,
yeah. You can go into the audience, Donahue style, and start talking to people.
Actually, he used an electric bass on a lot of the tracks. So that part was easy for me. And then the synth, I mean, there are a couple of songs where I decide to hang back a little bit and just let the bass synth sub do its thing. Because otherwise, I were a little bit competing for that frequency. So,
do you find like you take a different approach to playing the kind of more dancey, poppy stuff than like the harder rock?
You know, so the way that I do it, if I'm learning somebody else's songs, I will try to learn it literally like note for note, style wise, and everything. The only main difference is, I probably personally use a pick less, but these songs really lend themselves to using a pick more often. Of course, tonight I'm using my fingers more, but I've got the pick in the set.
Do you prefer finger picking to picking normally, or does it just depend on the style?
It just depends on the song. I find that when I'm using my fingers on my right hand, my left hand actually acts differently. Like, if I'm playing with a pick, my left hand, I lose a little bit of fluidity. Like, I just can't execute super intricate lines as well as I can if I were using my fingers. So,
interesting. Do you feel like your mind kind of works together that way to make it happen in this?
I have to focus a little bit more. Like, if I'm using a pick, I really have to focus that much more. But sometimes you just need a pick in a song. So, sorry, bass players, you know. Sometimes you just need.
No, one thing I'm a part-time bass player sometimes. And I always find that if you play with your fingers and you get those calluses, you can always pick up a pick. But if you don't play with your fingers, you can't just decide to do it and play three sets. You're going to get blisters. But you are well-versed in the finger-picking of the bass, and I'm sure you have those calluses built up nice and strong.
Yeah, you know, I lost them a little bit during COVID because I just wasn't playing, which
another
is
victim
silly.
Of COVID, Julie's calluses.
I know. I really had to get them back in shape. But, you know, it just takes a few practices and they're back. So
wonderful. Well, you sound amazing tonight. I think we might be ready for the second half of your set. I don't want to talk to Benji. Get out of here, Benji.
No one does. It's fine. No. He wasn't here.
All right. Well, here comes Ilithios. Round two. Stay tuned.
the ball.
I got it.
Hey, John, can you skip to the video like 5 minutes in and just play from there?
No problem.
Like 5 or 6 minutes. We're going really quickly through this set because nerves? Nerves?
Nice. When you put on fancy suits, time gets better.
I bought the suit thinking that like live shows would be a thing, and I was thinking that like, because I like to dress up with my band Caddy, and I was like, I'm gonna buy a bunch of nice clothes so I can play out and like play bass and focus on just like looking nice in a suit, and then that didn't happen. Thanks, Obama. That was a terrible bit. Okay. It just dawned on me what we're going to do next, and it's just like, wow. Wow. So this is our second to last song, so we're going to have a friend of ours. I should have planned this set. No.
Wait. Let me tune.
Worst drummer ever.
Worst. this is our second to last song. I'm gonna on the record of my bandmate Anna Becker, who is running the chat. She's like in the chat room, just like say hi, everyone. She helped out with the song. She sang on it, so she's gonna come and help sing on it tonight as well. So Anna Becker, ladies and gentlemen. Yo, pay your respects in the chat. F F F F F F. Close your boat. Okay, so here we go. This is dedicated to Mama Meller. All right. Thank you, we have one more song. Make sure you all are chatting it up. Everyone say nice things in the chat about everyone playing. Say nice things about Anna. Pay. Throw donations if you feel so compelled. Thank you, Zach, Jen, Stephen Perry, and John Daly, of course, for doing this incredible, incredible, incredible thing with this space. bandNada is amazing. And if you're watching this and you haven't signed up yet, like, don't do Instagram live streams. Don't do the Facebook ones. They have enough people doing that. This is way cooler. So let's do it. Last song. Thank you. Thank you so much for having us. Everyone follow bandNada and everyone be beautiful and happy. Love you.
Someone help me up.